My people, I greet you now for everywhere where now day. Today, as they pass, as they check me some things online, I can't see waiting a bit say, God no create me, make I can't see that kind of thing. God no create me, make I see that kind of life they exist, I go keep quiet. So I can't say, make I can't talk and for here. Should in case, so that many years we go hear them, if it be say some go feel help. Some will no feel help, when you're not there in their capacity or in their ability to help, that at least if they help me share this video, it go reach people where go feel help. So I beg, may everybody share this video so that it go reach people when you supposed reach, where go feel take action because of this thing. Because the rate where intimidation, where people take, they intimidate people, they suffocate people, maybe because they get money past you, or they feel say they know the cabans past you, they know police, you know, they get police for their pocket, for their palm, anything where they talk, police officers go do. Then the other force men around, they go feel say they be God for the country where they call Nigeria. Intimidation everywhere. So now the matter, now I'm going to talk for years, I'm going to talk for years. And this matter, now be matter where be say, man, old man and woman, we don't hustle for life, we don't suffer, make ends meet. Provide waiting they go take, they sustain for their life during old time. Now government carry, just, I don't know whether na government, one camp people, some group of people just carry come. Maybe because see, they feel see, they get money, they get level, they get assessment for their hand, for their pocket. They feel see, they go come collect the waiting they no labor for. It makes sense. Country of democracy. So the matter with me won't talk with this. Now this man, I go play now because me, I don't get too much talk to talk. I go show una me una hear from them. The video, una go watch and na where these people they talk on. So they need help. You understand? This thing happened as of April. So but the video now on the 29th, I'll be on the thing of the 29th, the person of this November we pass, so now the person will post the video, where the video they post up. So now I might see him and the thing verse me, I say man, I can't talk on. But something, invest center where people, where they don't use their money, build everything to arrange normal, where they don't, they operate for up to 12 years or even more than 12 years. All of a sudden, some group of people come with SARS, hefty force men, come hijack the place. The people they talk, police, nobody want listen to them. Why? Why? It don't make sense. The level of oppression in Nigeria is high. There is no human right in Nigeria. And the thing is so alarming, dangerously alarming. Nigeria is not a good inhabitant at all. Nigeria is so scary to live for the citizens. So the matter, I say, man, I bring them for you. Now the video be this one. Men are watching, men are see everything by yourself. If you don't watch and finish, I beg share and please.
Good afternoon, Nigerian. I am Mrs. Adeoyo. I run an event center on 33A Ejigbo Road, Okeafa. We've been operating this property since almost 12 years ago now. But unfortunately, on the 18th of April, we saw SARS men in uniform, fully armed with some mufti men. We saw them jumping over our property at 30 Egbe Road that was meant to be the parking space for our event center. We went there to approach them what was happening, only for one Mayaki Anza Alfa to be telling us that he led the SARS men from Abuja to the land, that the owner of the land want to take possession. Which land, we don't know. That is the land we've been operating since over 10 years. My husband bought that land with his gratuity after retirement from Guinness. Since on the 18th, the policemen, they've been terrorizing us. We went there to ask them, after telling us that they are from Abuja, Amza said he led them from there. They made him to sit on the floor, collected his phone, held him hostage, they started pulling down all the trees and the beautification we did on the parking. After doing all this, they made him to sit down, started digging. That same day they started building. They constructed with the help of the SARS men in uniform, using Scorpio t-shirts to cover their uniform. They started building. After several hours, they had to take my husband away to an unknown place. I ran out to a Ejigbo police station to complain to the DPO. The DPO said it's a land matter, it's a civil, she used one grammar. And even before attending to me, they started tossing me around. I went upstairs, go downstairs, this, running up and down. No attention was given to me by the DPO of Ejigbo. They didn't even allow me to write statements. Why standing there creating scene? Someone called me from the parking where the assessmen are protecting the land grabbers constructing the building same day that they've taken my husband away with a tinted car. No number. I have to run back from the Ejigbo police station again to the site. Getting there, I asked them, where's my husband? He was nowhere to be found. I started calling my husband's phone number. I couldn't reach him. Switched off. I went back to Ejigbo again to meet the DPO to tell her that, oh, I came here in land matter. You said it's evil. Now they've taken my husband away. She said it with her own mouth that this is kidnapping. What should be done? If she just said it's kidnapping, started going up and down, not even giving me attention. No statement was written whatsoever. People started calling me, asking me how far. I started calling as well how far. Someone now sent me a number that I should call Mushin. I called the number. The Oga there answered. I said, Oga, I have a problem. He come to my head. He said, what is happening? I told him that such men are on our property building. I went to Ejigbo. Even that is not the matter now, as I told him. I said, they've kidnapped my husband. I don't know where to find. All this Oga could tell me is not his jurisdiction. That should go back to Ejigbo. I went back to meet BC again. Nothing was done until night. My husband now called me. I went back to meet him. Now narrated what happened. They took him away, that they are taking him to SAS office, only to branch an uncompleted building where he met some men there. And they now told him what happened, that they heard that they are working on the land, they're supposed to take him to office, but they want Muritala, the man they met is Muritala, Tajuddin Muritala, and they met one man there, to who his name is Adebusola Kesta, with Fatai. I'm
Modu. Nigerians, please, so Tajuddin Muritala is terrorizing us. Mayaki Suleiman Sat Alfa is terrorizing us. Mayaki is boasting that he has police in his pocket because the former IG, Alhaji Idris, is his cousin. Nigerians, please, police should not be the tools in the hand of privileged people. We are law abiding citizens. We bought this land genuinely with our gratuity. Please, Nigerians, help us.
Please, may everybody, if you know you are capable to help, please help them. If you could, those that are not capable to help, please share this video so that it will get to those people that can help these people. Please, my people, let's fight corruption and injustice in Nigeria because it is getting too much. That is why we, the Igbo, we are agitating Biafra. Now, so the matter be. You know why? Because now me be Onyechukwu Meze. A child that wants to know the cause of his parents' death must be ready to dance to the tune of Sungada, which is Egundemo. My brother, you not go, you not know. Now, so the matter be. One love.